gunners were met with a deputation of local people who went out to them and said, would they please mind moving their guns away? Because the vibration is cracking the toilet bowls and flooding the bathrooms. I mean, for Pete's sake, these fellas are eyeball to eyeball with Hitler's Luftwaffe. Someone's worried about his toilet bowls. Leading astronomers and mathematicians have worked there for hundreds of years. That's where they gave us the zero meridian. That's where the world divides east and west, you know. It's where they gave us longitude, the air railroads, Greenwich Mean Time. It's the timepiece for the world. Oh, in 1764, there was an argument going on between Mr. William Penn's Pennsylvania and Lord Baltimore's Maryland. They could never figure out exactly where their boundary line was. So, in the end, in frustration, they appealed to the king. The argument had been going on for 80 years. Send us out a couple of your royal astronomers from Greenwich, alongside the River Thames, with their instruments, you know, to do the alignment with the stars, to do the surveying, to do the map making, and draw us a line. The two men that the king sent out from alongside the River Thames here to draw that line were a Mr. Mason and a Mr. Dixon. And of course they drew a rather famous line, didn't they? They only did 300 miles, because when they'd gone 300 miles, the Indians said, you go any further, we're going to kill you. So they thought, well, we better stop here. And it was finished off by other people, but of course it remains to this day the Mason-Dixon line. And then, before we get down to Tower Bridge, there's still time for me to tell you the story of another Thames waterman. And his story goes, he left his name on his mark on the history of North America. Over 200 years ago, a young captain was working in and out of here, the Pool of London, on an ocean-going trader called the Betsy of London. This young captain was working and saving and dreaming of the day when he could buy himself a plantation on Virginia. He wanted to be a Virginia landowner, a Virginia gentleman. These dreams were shattered by the outbreak of the War of Independence. And this young captain, in common with many, many other young British fellows, decided to throw in his lot with the colonies. So he sailed away and offered his services to the colonies as a fighting sea captain. They took him on, and for some reason, we don't know why, he added to his own name the name of an old family friend. So instead of announcing himself, as he was known here in the Pool of London, as Captain John Paul, he called himself Captain John Paul Jones. And his tomb you can see to this day, where it quite rightly rests, in the crypt of the chapel of the United States Naval Academy at Annapolis, where he is generally regarded as the founder of the United States Navy. He has that famous phrase, I have not yet begun to fight. So you see, ladies and gentlemen, when we set out from over there, look on the left from Tower Pier, and I said to you, I hope to illustrate to you in a small way that when you're on the river...